Hi everyone, welcome to the Python math section. In this video, I'm going to tell you the ways to find out the prime factors of an integer. So the idea is like this. I just do the division repeatedly by using prime numbers so that the remainder for each of the divisions is 0. So I do the repeated divisions until the final quotient is just a prime number. Or I can just do the division repeatedly until I get the final quotient to be 1. And then, in the course of the division process, I just store the prime factors after each division that returns a remainder of 0. So that means the prime factors are found. And if they are found, I just store those prime factors. Now, let us see an example of the prime factor evaluation. Suppose I want to find the prime factors of 60. So I try 2 to be the divisor, which is the smallest prime number. So I get 30 as the quotient. And then I can also try 2 once again, so that the division gives me 15. Now, is it able to try 2 again? No, because the division of 15 by 2 gives me a remainder of 1. So I have to try another prime number. So let me try the next prime number, which is 3. So when I do the division of 15 by 3, I get 5. Can I try 3 again as the divisor? No, because the division of 5 by 3 gives me a remainder of 2. So I have to try another prime number, which is 5. And when I do the division of 5 by 5, I get the quotient as 1, and the remainder is 0. So in this case, the final quotient becomes 1, and that means I've already finished the prime factor division. Okay, we just end the division when the quotient is 1. And the divisors are just the prime numbers being used as the divisors. So we have 2, 2, 3, and 5 being the prime factors. Now let me go to the implementation. So before I do anything, I have to accept the input from the user. And then I have to create a list to store the prime factors coming out of my repeated divisions. So now I have an empty list that wants to store the prime factors coming from the divisions. And the next thing is that I want to try 2 to be the divisor. And I also hope that I can make use of 2 to do the division repeatedly. So in this case, I just want the value of 2 to help me do the divisions as many as it can. If the division by 2 gives me a remainder of 0, I just append the value of 2 to the factors list. And then I have to update my number. So now, the next number will be the number obtained by dividing the original number by 2. Here, I use integer division because I'm already sure that the next number coming from the division gives me a remainder of 0. And if the prime factor of 2 has been tried to its fullest, then we have to try another prime number, which is 3. So after the while loop has been executed completely, I have to try another divisor, which is 3. And 3 is the next prime number after 2, okay? So while these conditions are satisfied, I will update the number. And of course, I also include the prime factors into the factors list. So these conditions are like that. We know that we can do the division until we reach 1 as the final quotient. So when the number is not yet equal to 1, I have to continuously do the division. And we also know that the divisor has to be smaller than the number. it is impossible for the divisor to be larger than the number. Otherwise, the quotient will be smaller than 1. So if the number is divisible by the trial divisor, it means that the given divisor is actually a prime factor. So I put it to the factors list, and of course I have to update the number. Okay, so the next number will be put to the while loop again to do repeated division if necessary. Now the divisor is 3. How about the situation when the divisor cannot give me a remainder of 0? In this case, I have to update the divisor to another possible prime factor. Okay, I just add the divisor by 2. So why do I need to add 2? Since the divisor is now 3, when I add 2, the divisor will become 5, which is another prime number. And if 5 is not able to satisfy the if condition here, then the next divisor will become 7. And you can imagine that the divisor will become other odd numbers. And we are already sure that except 2, other prime numbers are odd. So that's why we can try only the odd numbers after 3. Okay, so that's why we can try odd numbers from upcoming attempts. And it is possible that we will make a divisor to be a composite number. So how about this situation? When the divisor becomes a composite number, we are pretty sure that the division shown here doesn't give me a remainder of 0. Why? Let me write down the reason. So the reason is like this. If a divisor is a composite number, for example, 9 or 15, this divisor must fail the test of the divisibility shown here. Because the factors of this particular divisor have been tested previously, so when the divisor becomes 15, which is an odd number, the number at that stage must not be divisible by 15 because the factors of that number have been tried already. So we have tried 3 and we have also tried 5. So before we try 15, it means that we already tried 3 and 5. And after we have tried 3 and 5, the number coming from the subsequent divisions will not be divisible by the product of the 2 prime numbers. So we are pretty sure that we won't be able to save a composite number as the factors. So the idea is complete. Then I can just play with this algorithm. Now I just print out the prime factors stored in the factors list. So let me try the program. I try 96. We can see that we have 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, and 3 being the prime factors. How about 1? Actually, the input of 1 is not sensible because 1 is not regarded as a prime number. And we know that 1 is equal to 1 times 1 times 1 and so on. So it is insensible to try 1 here. And how about other values? So if I try 360, we see that we have 3 2s 2 3s and 1 5 being the prime vectors. So the program has already shown you the prime vectors of a given integer. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.